Hello everyone, a very good afternoon. Welcome to this incredible experience. It's one of those pinch me moments, I think, in life, that we're here in this wonderful theatre. Thanks so much for having us today to see this world premiere of an extraordinary project. And it's one of those things in life where, you know, they say the journey of 1,000 miles starts with the first step. Mark, who is on his way, as I'm sure some of you all know, we, like many others, have been caught up in all of the storm and so on, everything today. But he called me in March of 2022 and said we were going to do this amazing project with the Bergen Philharmonic and this piece, the Delius Mass of Life. And I have to confess, I didn't know it. I knew of it. I'd heard bits, literally, after in Bergen, which is the instrumental music that starts part two. Otherwise, it was a new work to me. But Mark, being extraordinarily persuasive, as we all know, convinced me that it was a really, really good project and really exciting. We were going to teach it and learn it throughout the summer of 2022, ahead of going over to Bergen in September to record the performance, and then Choir of the Earth would sing along with it. A simple task, you might think, but as of course with a project of this size, it was a huge undertaking and something that required a huge amount of effort and love, really, from everyone who was involved. My first rehearsal for it was an epic one in itself, nearly 3 hours of rehearsal to teach a couple of the lines in the first movement, and I had the real feeling of climbing a mountain. And speaking of which, I think that might be Mark Straughan himself. Just been killing time till you got here, Mark, so it's really good to see you. And so there we were in 2022, in the summer, teaching this piece during the incredible heat wave, I'm sure you'll remember, where it was 40 plus degrees, and I was in my little studio teaching Delius. And I did for a moment think, what have I done to deserve this? Here I am, sweltering, teaching this phenomenally difficult music, some of the most challenging music in the choral repertoire. But the funny thing happened throughout that summer, and indeed in September, as we made our way over to Bergen, I fell completely and utterly in love with this amazing piece. It's gone from a piece I didn't know to one that I can't really imagine my life without. And of course, so many of us here took part in the recording for this. Just give me a wave if your voice is going to be heard shortly coming out of this amazing screen. And I think everyone also watching along at home, because we're going to be premiering this on Monday on YouTube, you will also agree this is an incredible piece. It has, the orchestration is vast. It calls for one of the largest orchestras in all of choral music. Two harps, massive brass section, huge woodwinds, fields of strings. When we saw it live in Norway, even knowing what was going to happen, just to see the orchestra take its place was quite overwhelming in itself. You have a massive choir, in this case you have an even bigger choir, and you have incredible vocal soloists, none more so important than of course the lead baritone, who is Zarathustra himself, sung today for us by the great Roderick Williams. So the entire project was a dream to work on. Musically, it was a challenge. And those of us who recorded multiple parts of this will agree, it's some of the most challenging music that we've ever done. But the end result is just spectacular. When it all came together as mixed by our lead engineer here, Connor, and his amazing team, well, the results that I heard were really, I think, some of the best music that we've produced as Choir of the Earth. And so I'm immensely proud of everyone who took part in this project, whether they watched it, whether they learned it and sang and recorded, whether they mixed it, whether they were part of the team that helped bring this together. What you're about to see is the result of literally tens of thousands of hours of work from both the Bergen Philharmonic and their choir, and of course Choir of the Earth, who are all working individually at home and sending their parts in to produce this extraordinary video. And the video itself was produced by the Bergen Philharmonic. They incorporated, as you'll see, into the footage that was shot at the actual event live, and you're going to see all sorts of wonderful angles of the orchestra and choir. They produced a new cut of this, so this is not the same version that went out live when we watched it over the internet. And of course, they've also incorporated the Choir of the Earth images into this project. So this really is, I think, a world first. It is a blended performance of live music as captured in person in Bergen in September of last year, but of course incorporating a digital choir for the first time for a complete work all the way through. And we are very privileged, I think, to be here to hear this world premiere. So as you're here, Mark, do you want to say anything at this point?
Yes, I'm it, may I?
Of course, I know we're going to play you a little example in a moment, but first of all, do we have the slide for Mark? There he is. There he is. Can we welcome Mark, freshly arrived?
Hello, everybody. Lovely to see you. Thank you so much for coming. Sorry, we're a bit late. It's the storm, you know, the storm. This is a very, very special moment for me personally. And if I may I just spend a minute or two being introspective into myself? I first heard this piece about 14 years ago on the A303 to London. Driving in the car, as we were, Ben, today, I heard this piece of music that came onto the radio, and it was transfixing. It was a horn, a French horn, with quiet strings, muted quiet strings. And then another horn. And I thought to myself, that must be an echo, because it was almost exactly the same as the first. And then a third horn. And I had to stop the car, because you know when you're driving, you can't always, well, you can't write down. So I stopped and I wrote down, the announcer told me it was by Frederick Delius and it was called A Mass of Life. So as is my wont, I just love music, whether it's King Crimson or Genesis or Frank Sinatra or Mozart or now Delius, I had to listen to the whole thing. It was difficult, it was hard. And it starts with this huge bang. And it was only afterwards that I realized that Delius ripped out the first 10 pages of the score, and page one is page 11. The first 10 pages are actually missing, so we don't quite know how he really started A Mass of Life, but he decided that he wanted to start it with a bang. So it was hard, but it gives back so much. And when we started Choir of the Earth, and we did Messiah, I think I shared with Ben one or two bits of the Mitternachtslied and Auf den Bergen. And I think he thought that they were quite nice, and that was probably about it. It was when I heard that Bergen were going to do the Norwegian premiere in September 2022 that I fired off a quick email on behalf of the whole choir to say, is there anything we can do together? Expecting nothing to happen at all. To my great surprise, I got an email back saying, that sounds interesting, let's have a chat. So I had a phone call, we discussed how it would work. They said, that sounds a great idea, why don't we do this? In fact, I think they used the marvellous words, why not? Let's give this a go. So I then made the most important phone call, ladies and gentlemen, of this whole project. Ben, would you do this? Because if you won't do it, we won't do it either. So it's all dependent upon you. And bless him, Ben said that he would do it.
Why not, I believe.
I couldn't imagine anybody else teaching us all Mass of Life. Ben, I think it's fair to say, has grown to love this piece of music. I hope, Connor, that you've grown to enjoy it as well. And thank you for all your amazing work and the team on putting all of this together. More thank yous later. But we have produced, ladies and gentlemen, something very, very special. And I never ever thought that I would be standing in front of you all today about to announce this incredible piece of music. It is, in my opinion, a masterpiece. It is a forgotten masterpiece. And I think we can be very proud of the fact that we have, in our own way, worked on this project. We can put it away, bank it as something that we have done. So thank you to you all for everything that you've done to bring this amazing project to life. More thank yous later. And on that note, I don't know if we're ready to roll, but well, if...
Before we do. What we have, just yes. To illustrate the enormity of the project, we've got three very short little extracts to play you. The first that you're going to hear is the opening 30 seconds of The Mass of Life, this big bang that starts this off. And what this is the sound as recorded in the Grieghallen here in the heart of Bergen with the orchestra and the choir that were there on the day. Could we have that file, please? Fabulous. Now, the second file we have is Choir of the Earth on their own. Because, of course, what we do is we get everyone around the world to learn these pieces, to sing them along with the guide tracks, and then they are blended together. So if we could have the second file, please. This is Choir of the Earth a cappella. To say, I think we are the first people other than the team to ever hear a choir sing that a cappella. Now what happens now is our wonderful engineers combine what was there on the day with the work of literally months and months and months and people working hard to produce this very special blend. So here is the mix of the two. Thank you. Is what we're about to experience, a combination of the sound as recorded live in Bergen under the incredible direction of Sir Mark Elder, the Bergen Philharmonic Choir and Orchestra, and the wonderful voices of Choir of the Earth. We're going to have an interval at the same point that they would have been in the concert, so it's about 40 minutes through, and you'll have an opportunity then to go and get some refreshments and come back for the second part, which is longer. The entire thing lasts about an hour and a half and is going to take you through the journey of the life of Zarathustra as he ascends to the peak of his existence and then looks at the end of his life. And the very last movement, of course, many of you will know, is the first piece that was written, the Mitternachtslied Zarathustras, and that's the work, that very last movement, that incredible midnight tune which inspired the entire work. So we are so proud and so pleased to welcome you all to this incredible event. Can I ask you to just double check your phones are on silent? So in the middle of one of the sensitive arias and so on, we aren't interrupted by a ringtone. And of course, we're not expecting a fire drill, but if you do hear an alarm, you can see where the exits are. And oxygen masks will drop from the ceiling. So everyone... The exit can indeed be behind you. So it's my huge pleasure and privilege to introduce Delius's A Mass of Life. Thank you.
Thank you. erhebt eure Herzen, meine Brüder, hoch, höhe, und vergesst mir auch die Beine nicht. Erhebt auf eure Beine, ihr guten Tänzer, und besser noch, ihr steht auch auf dem Kopf. Diese Krone des Lachenden, diese Rosenkranzkrone, ich selber setzte mir diese Krone auf. Ich selber sprach heilig meine Gelächter. Keinen anderen fand ich heute stark genug dazu. Dem Winde tut mir gleich, wenn er aus seinen Berghöhen stürzt. Nach seinen eigenen Pfeife will er tanzen. Die Meere zittern und hüpfen unter seinen Fußtapfen. Diesen Krone des Lachenden, diese Rosenkranzkrone euch, meinen Brüdern, werfe ich diese Krone zu. Ha! Das Lachen sprach ich heilig, ihr höheren Menschen, lernt mir lachen.
Bye. Zu dir hin sprang ich, da flohst du zurück vor meinem Sprunge, und gegen mich züngelte deines fliehenden Fliegen.
Freunde, ihr Wunderlichen, Die Zeit hin sank ich nicht in tiefe Brunnen. Lieber will ich sterben, sterben, als euch sagen, was mein Mitternacht
ist das
Alle springen. Enden. lasst vom Tanze nicht ab, ihr lieblichen Mädchen. Kein Spielverderber kam zu euch mit bösem Blick, kein Mädchenfeind. Gottes Fürsprecher bin ich vor dem Teufel, der aber ist der Geist der Schwere. Wie sollte ich ihr leichten, göttlichen Tänze Feind sein? Oder Mädchenfüßen mit schönen Knöcheln. Wohl bin ich ein Wald und eine Nacht dunkle Bäume, doch wer sich vor meinem Dunkel nicht scheut, der findet auch Rosenhänge unter meinen Zypressen. Und auch den kleinen Gott findet er wohl, der den Mädchen der Liebste ist, neben dem Brunnen. Liegt er still mit geschlossenen Augen. Wahrlich, am hellen Tag schlief er mir ein, der Tagedieb. Hascht er wohl zu viel nach Schmetterlingen? Zürnt mir nicht, ihr schönen Tanzenden, wenn ich den kleinen Gott ein wenig züchtige, schreien wird er wohl und weinen, aber zum Lachen ist es noch im Weinen und mit Tränen im Auge soll er euch um einen Tanz bitten, und ich selber will ein Lied zu seinem Tanze singen. Eine Tanz- und Spottlied auf den Geist der Schwere. Meinen allerhöchsten, großmächtigsten Teufel, von dem sie sagen, dass er der Herr der Welt sei.
Thank you. Sonne ist lange schon hinunter. Die Wiese ist feucht von den Wäldern her.
ein zierlicher Wind ungesehen aufgetäfelte Meere tanzt leicht wieder leicht so tanzt der Schlaf auf mir das ist die heimliche, feierliche Stunde, wo kein Hirt die Flöte bläst.
Was geschah mir? Horch, flog die Zeit wohl davon? Fall ich nicht, fiel ich nicht, horch, in den Brunnen der Ewigkeit? O zerbrich!
Thank you. Thank you. kommt, kommt. Lasst uns jetzt so wandern. Es ist die Stunde. Lasst uns
auch aller Lärm wie sie heimlich, schrecklich, herzlich zu dir redet.
Ah!
on a project like this, there are so many people to thank. What a wonderful, wonderful project it's been. And if you'll excuse me, I'm just going to use my phone because otherwise I'll forget somebody and that would be a complete disaster. First of all, I'd like to thank Bergen for all their help and support, the Bergen Philharmonic Orchestra and Chorus. I'd like to thank Eric for putting the video together and his team. I'd like to thank Håkon. Håkon, thank you for all your wonderful support in getting this project up and running and involving us so wonderfully. I'd like to thank Bernd for his support in allowing Choir of the Earth to become part of this project. I'd like to thank Roderick Williams for all his wonderful help in the conversation that he had with the choir about how he approaches this wonderful piece. I'd also like to thank Sir Mark Elder and David Hill, who also were kind enough to talk to Ben and myself and the choir about how we as choristers can look at and get the most out of this amazing piece of music. I'd like to thank the Delius Society for advertising this project that we've done on A Mass of Life to their members. I'd also like to thank the Delius Trust, who contributed to the costs of this course, so thank you so much. And we shall be making a contribution by giving our backing tracks and rehearsal tracks to the Trust to allow other choirs maybe to learn this piece more quickly than they might otherwise have done. I'd like to thank Richard Gowers, who did a piano reduction of A Mass of Life, which we then gave to the Fieri Consort. Thank you, Fieri, for doing your wonderful singing and creating our wonderful rehearsal tracks. All of these tracks were recorded by the Fieri Consort with voice part louder, so that we were able to use these during our teaching. I'd like to thank Mark and Nikki in the Choir of the Earth team for their wonderful support in making this project happen, come to life, and come to such a wonderful conclusion. Thank you. I'd like to thank Ben. Oh, Ben! Ben, thank you so much for your professionalism, your musicality, for your good sense of humour, for also saying yes, you would teach this, because if it hadn't been for you, your agreement, we would have found it more difficult. So Ben, thank you for everything you've done in teaching this music with such great humour and musicality to people from all over the world. And finally, a great thanks to you, to the choir who trusted us, trusted Ben and myself in coming on this journey with a piece that is lesser known, but nonetheless, I hope you now agree with us, it's one of the greatest pieces of choral music ever written. And so thank you to everybody making this project come true, and it's the beginning of many, many more things to come. Thank you.